an interview with Randy and a YouTube, one of my YouTube subscribers, and her name is Lady V. Her name is Lady V. I just met her for the first time. Talk to me about the channel.
Oh, well, about the channel.
In Jamaican language.
I find the channel very informative and entertaining.
Mm-hmm.
For me, I get addicted to that because it's genuinely real. This is real stuff you're getting on the channel.
Mm-hmm.
It's a talk to you in Jamaica.
So now, you, Lady V, how many years you been in Jamaica?
In Jamaica?
I mean, in America.
So 9 years.
9 years?
Yes. But like, I go back every year.
And what parish?
I'm from Kingston, Suffolk.
So you grew up in Kingston all your life?
All my life. I grew up in Kingston, 7. I was born there.
You're from a farming family?
Yes, my mother is a farmer. And she farms in Kingston also. Which a lot of people might say, oh, but you can't farm at Kingston. Which part of land they farm? But I've never known my mother without a field. So all my life, I knew my mother always farming. My father's side of family is from Manchester, Grovetown, and they're a farming family too, so.
It's such a pleasure to meet Jamaicans who watch the channel in Brooklyn, and I get to meet them. This movement is turning into a big family. When you talked to me initially, when you called me, you told me about your grandmother, and I was so interested. You know, and I said to you, I want you to be a part of the program. Part of cultural preservation is actually meeting the people, talk to them about their experience, you know, things you love to eat and things. So, you know, spill the beans. We won't forget for no Lady V, because your energy, you have a thing where you go into your grandmother vibe. I'm going to say, wow, this woman is interesting, you know?
Well, my grandmother, she was Catherine Raymond.
I don't cut that out. My grandmother was such and such, but you don't want to put her name.
Oh. And she's from Grovetown, Manchester. She passed away when she was 107.
Wow.
She was a blessed soul. My grandmother. As I said, I would interview her. I would literally go and interview her. And like you said, when I talked to you in gym, in my grandmother voice, and she said, I said, Grandma, how did you meet Granddad? But I've never met my grandfather. And she said, no, shop my parents send me go. My parents send me a shop when me look this man a call me, both in one talk to me. Mr. Martha Galanya coming out, turn up a road talk to no man. You have to go ask my parents for me. I'm saying, Grandma, it's not parents, it's parents. Appearance me no. Appearance. And you know, she tell me, oh, you come to the house and him have to, like, go to the bush, bring wood for the fire, because you know they use wood fire. He must bring wood for the fire, follow my grandfather to the field and do a lot of work in just to get her. But eventually he did. He did got her, they got married. But he passed away after his 8th child was about 12 years old. So he passed away young.
Wow.
But she has never been with another person. So I said, Grandma, why you don't get another man? I see him the one Joe Brown I talk about. Lad Catherine, like a whole you but dead. And gone, make your uncle. I say, Galang, this a body are you but one. I'm like, Grandma, it's not you but, it's you bird, a you but in name. And you know, basically she would have tell me things like when she was growing up, what it was like, the hardship that she, you know, experienced. But at the time she said she didn't know that she was really poor, because this is what she knew. This is all she knew her life. My grandfather was a butcher and a farmer. So they would farm the food. And when my grandfather killed animal, they would have the meat. So they always have food. It's not like nowhere. Even in the country now, some of them, they don't want to plant. And I can't understand that. I have a cousin who lives same place in Grovetown.
Grovetown.
And every time I go down there, she would be. Then when you come, you come from town with your two long hands. I can't cut them short. I can't cut them short because you are here. You can plan something. I don't mind carrying things there. But you don't look for me to carry certain things, food stuff from town,
mm-hmm.
come country to give you. I remember I went to Portland, and a friend of mine saw this lady with some coconut. I'm like, whoa, look at coconut. So we asked the lady for some of the coconuts. So I said, we could plant them. But my yard, we don't have any space to plant, because we have some of the things planted already.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, let me take it to Manchester. And I had a chocho that was growing. And I go down there, I said, Grandma, I'm going to plant this chocho for you and I. And that same cousin was like, oh, like how my diabetes, I have diabetes, I can't get chocho. I said, no, if you pick one off, I'm going to kill the tree. Because me not supposed to leave Kingston, mm-hmm. come a country, come plant a tree for mm-hmm. you to get it, and you here not planting it.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So these are some of the things that disgust me with even just the people, and not only for country people. Because
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
when I live in Jamaica, I have my backyard garden.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I had sweet pepper, callaloo, pop chow, Indian kale, okra, gongo peas, you name it, I had it. I remember one day I was cooking and my daughter said, Mommy, everything you cook, you put okra in it. I said, because them upon the tree, what am I going to do with it? Make them spoil? No, I'm going to cook it and eat it. This is what I grow. I'm going to enjoy eating what I grow.
How many kids you have now?
Two.
Two. What age?
Well, my big daughter is 34,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
and my youngest is 23. So
you work hard in America to get your nurse's aid?
Yes.
How many years?
8 years.
8 years of doing that.
Oh.
So you come from Kingston, 7 straight to Brooklyn?
Yes.
Wow. So what's the exit plan?
Well, right now I built a house in Jamaica, same place in Kingston 7.
Yeah,
since I'm here, it's more like a boarding house because I live close, like 5 minutes from the University of the West Indies.
Mm-hmm.
So,
wow.
I build and rent to student. Mm. That's what I'm doing now.
Nice.
And for when I'm ready to go back home, because that's home,
mm-hmm.
then I have somewhere to stay.
Wonderful.
I have a house on my own. So that's basically it with me. But
that's just beautiful. So now you see the village we're building. You see, I'm building a kind of a network of people who are proficient in certain things. Mm-hmm. Your contribution to village, you're into health.
Yes.
Pretty much. The bush and the herbs, them, are you going to apply some of our knowledge to your lifestyle? What have you started to?
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Well, like the bush, I know quite a few of them.
Yeah.
I know, like, search my aunt. What is one name?
This is amazing. People don't know. If you're in Brooklyn, link me, come. I can't just drive my car to interview. This is my first car interview with Lady V. I love her energy. I spoke to her initially. I'm like, wow, this woman know. She could channel her grandmother energy into, she's like a theatrical type where, you know, tell us about your friend saying you should have been in drama.
Oh, yeah. I have a friend, she teaches drama in Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember when she started drama school, she was like, Vanessa, why you don't come drama school anyway? You can't, listen, the way you can change up your voice. And you just act just like, if you're telling a story, you just act like the person. And I'm like, no. And she would quarrel with me every time. And like, even like when I'm telling her about my grandmother, and I say, my cousin came down from Canada, I want to give my grandmother a shower mm-hmm. for her 103 birthday. And she said, me I'm an invalid. Me can't be it myself. So my cousin like, no, Grandma, I want to give you a shower. Me say me an invalid, ma. Tan, you think me the invalid? But anyway, Sidi, my cousin Sidi was determined. So my Sidi a shower now, she said, when Sidi reach her private part, she said, eh, not touch this, oh, give me the rug. And you but who and touch this so? So no give no you not touchy. Make me wash down there. You know? So, these are the things that would keep me with that close to my grandmother.
Yeah, yeah.
It definitely keep me close to her. And me, losing my grandmother was a big loss for me, because this is somebody who I could talk to about almost anything. It's not like, oh, you can say, I can't talk to my grandmother about sex because grandma, no. No, she gonna talk to you. Listen, you get one little man, and you and him are croton. I mean, croton, when she like croton, I'm like flowers. She said, croton. When I know croton, you know him first, get to know him. I don't know married. No make no man keep you in a sin. Make him take you out of sin. And you see, when you're not married, you have to compromise. No make, because your friend did tell you, say she see him down a road with one girl. Then you're going to break up your marriage and run for divorce. You know, she would advise you on all these things. Mm-hmm. Because she live it.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So she can actually tell us about it.
Mm-hmm.
When I was watching the YouTube channel, your YouTube channel,
mm-hmm.
and I said to my girlfriend, Bridget, I said, I was telling her about it, because my mother was born in St. Elizabeth, but she went to Kingston when she was five.
Mm-hmm.
So all her life, she grew up in Kingston.
Mm-hmm.
But we're from Augustown.
Mm-hmm.
And at that time when we were kids, they had a nine-night group.
Mm-hmm.
You know, set up.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And we used to say, boy, it's like my mother would, like they would pray for somebody die,
mm-hmm.
just to go to Nine-Nine. And her stepfather was a part of the Nine-Nine crew.
Mm-hmm.
And he passed away the other day. She said, Van, I want you to sing, remind me of some of the old time Nine-Nine song.
Because
mm-hmm. I was saying to her, don't go down there, I have a Nine-Nine where music are playing.
Mm-hmm.
I said, that's not him. I said, we call him Mr. Six. Mr. Mm-hmm. Six was somebody who was from the old school Nine-Night.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So you have to do whatever he used to do back in his days.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, I don't remember. And then, I started singing to them. And she said, put it on WhatsApp and send it to me. So I did a couple of them, sent it to her. And she started sending them to her family member in Jamaica. And she said, oh, Van, everybody call me. I ask me who the... No, Vanessa can't sing like that because she stole... I'm like, crazy.
Sing one of them. We get a Nine-Night time tonight. Randy Ponder Radio. I'm in Brooklyn right now. Go to JamaicaRadio.com, and I want you guys to get the number. Call me if you're in New York. I might be able to stop by. I'm leaving for Africa. You're going to hear a Nine-Night from Van. Van? Is what I'm calling you?
Yes.
Van. V-E-N?
Van, yeah.
Lady Van, go ahead, sing me something. This is culture at the best. Go ahead. Why am I telling
that good? Let me see if I can find one. I know a lot of people might not know these songs because they are from the old school.
Mm-hmm.
But growing up with my mother around us, going to Nine-Nine, we used to follow her anyways. Ooh. Lord upon the bank of the beautiful river, meet me dear, brother, will you meet me dear, right over there on the bank of the beautiful river, meet me dear when my journey is in. Da 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 dum bum da da woy. Brother, will you meet me dear, right over there on the bank of the beautiful river, meet me dear when my journey is in. And I I did that for her, and she said she wanted one for Mr. Six.
Splendid. Them are going to love it, Ben.
And Mr. Six was the favorite one for him.
Let it go.
Gates enemy, oh, gates enemy, oh, gates enemy, the old band's room. Say gates enemy, oh, gates enemy, oh, gates enemy, the old band's room. My Jesus prayed until he sweat became blood, brother, and it was worse for you, Lord, and it was for me, Lord. Oh, what an agony, oh, what a pain King Jesus bear. And then fast more they done gone, Lada de na bitter belly daya fi mind them. Fast more they done gone, and a bitter belly daya fi mind them. Lada way them day, you see them day magalang day. Lada way them day, you see them day magalang day. I wonder where them gone. I wonder where them gone. I wonder where the tether one gone.
I give thanks and blessings for you. I give thanks. You say, me give thanks and blessings for you. The people them that really touched Jamaica. I mean, you really kept the tradition.
I do. I try. And I teach my two girls. They know all these songs. They grew up on these songs because I would play them in the house. I would sing them at home.
Do you buy Nine Night music? Because I went to Manchester. So you have a collection?
Yeah, I have some home.
Wicked, yeah. Because I would love at some point you let me those get the MP3s because...
Yeah.
Let me tell you, I went to Jamaica one time in Manchester and I heard some music. I said to them, well, that music. And they said, that's the band's music. Mm-hmm. And it's so local and it's so rich with African fusion. Yes.
Because I was watching one of your YouTube videos and...
The Maroon Night Night Dance?
This one, it's the first I've ever heard somebody mention that name. They call it Eto. Mm-hmm. I went in Westmoreland, in this place, Grange. Not Grange Hill, Grange.
Mm-hmm.
With a friend of mine, Junior Beckford.
Mm-hmm.
He used the film for... JBC back then.
Mm-hmm.
And we went to country to film this thing. It was a Eto where they celebrate the life of the person. It's just like a Nine Night.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But I've never heard anybody with that word Eto until mm-hmm. I was watching your videos.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, wow, Eto. And it was in Westmoreland you did it. So I said, I'm going to find out if it's more of a Westmoreland thing.
Which one was that? Because I didn't want to send
Mary. I watched so much of them, I don't remember.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But I know the one that I watched when I talk about the Eto.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
It was in Westmoreland.
Okay. I have some more to upload. Wow, I tell you.
Jamaica. But in terms of keeping all these culture, the culture,
mm-hmm.
that is what I would love to see people keep the culture. When I tell my daughter about having a phone back then,
mm-hmm.
I said, it's like you can't live without the phone. If you go downstairs and you forget the phone, you have to run up upstairs.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Why? Back in the days, we never have phone. Mm-hmm. I understand, changes make. Yeah, and we change for the mm-hmm, so-called
mm-hmm.
better.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But we never have that. If somebody in the community have a phone, you say that person rich.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
If somebody have a fridge, you say the person rich.
Mm-hmm.
Because basically you have to just buy what you're going to cook.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You don't have a fridge to put it in.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
We used to wait on the ice truck. And when the ice truck come in, ice truck will come. And my mother would dig mm-hmm. a hole in the hearth,
mm-hmm.
put the sawdust in the hole,
mm-hmm.
and put the ice in a bag, put it in the hole, and cover it. And that would keep for days. For date, and this is not like I am 70 years old,
mm-hmm.
you know, but I can remember as a child, I can remember all of this.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So it's just to keep preserve the old culture, Jamaican culture. And some of us come, we migrate from Jamaica and we get caught up with the culture of wherever we migrated to.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And it's like, okay, for instance, somebody would hear me doing a Nine Nights song and say, I should go with them old song there.
Mm-hmm,
I wish
mm-hmm.
it, you understand me? Mm-hmm, but they don't mm-hmm. realize this is, it's a part of us.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Well, it's a part of me.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell, when I said to somebody, of course I'm African. And mm-hmm. they say, me not African, me a Jamaican.
Mm-hmm.
A Jamaican, I born away, you born. No. I say, if a pig was born in a cow pen, that don't mean the pig is a cow. It means a pig, right? So not the fact that you was born in Jamaica don't necessarily mean you're Jamaican.
Yeah, yeah.
Because your ancestors is from Africa.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Don't tell me, oh, a goat born in the pig pen, so the goat becomes a pig.
Yeah, yeah.
You understand? So preserving the culture is a big, big thing for me.
Yeah, yeah.
Every weekend I used to say, once I have guests and music in my car,
yeah,
I would drive down to Manchester.
Yeah.
And grandma said, my grand pick me, she never called me my name. My grand pick me, Lord God, you born and grew a town under the clock. And you love country, sir? I'm like, yes. The only thing I didn't like with Manchester is the red dirt.
You never liked the red dirt?
No, because it would stain your foot, it'd stain your clothes. But apart from that, everything country, that's me. Where my grandmother lives, we come out of the house.
Mm-hmm.
On the veranda, mm-hmm. and there's a tangerine tree there. You just pick a tangerine.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
All the fruits, Nisberry, mm-hmm. we have all of that.
Mm-hmm.
The Kingston, you don't really have that. Nowadays, enough of them down there don't want to plant, as I said before, like my cousin.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
She don't want to plant, and she have the land to plant.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
We have a family friend who is a neighbor of my grandmother. And every time I go country, she would be, oh, Katie, come go beg Sissy 2 tomato. I say, every time I come down here, you go beg Sissy 2 tomato. Why you don't plant some pepper that you can give Sissy 2 pepper and Sissy give you 2 tomato? You understand what I mean? Yeah. Do something. You have the land.
Yeah.
You have the land. You go have to. You live in another country mm-hmm. where you going to buy yam.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
No, me not gonna give you no money for buy the yam.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
If you tell me say you want to buy a piece of pork or something, yeah, fine.
Mm-hmm.
Cause me don't. Man, I'm not gonna give you the money to buy the chicken either. Cause you have place can raise 2 chicken.
Mm-hmm.
When I was growing up, my mother always have a farm. I tell you,
mm-hmm.
my mother raised fowl. She have the ones that. To lay,
mm-hmm.
they call them the layer, and she have the white fowl we should sell,
mm-hmm.
and we always have chicken in our house.
Mm-hmm.
So if she can live at Kingston and do all of that, why you can't do it? So I tell them I come to America and I work very, very hard,
mm-hmm.
like a lot of us, not just me. Mm-hmm. A lot of us, most of us come here, we work very hard, and I mm-hmm. work very hard,
mm-hmm.
and I achieve a little house,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Which is my investment. It's a part mm-hmm. of my investment. But at the same time, I can see where I come to America and achieve something back home.
Because mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. that's home.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So that's basically it with me.
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. I mean, I've been doing this for about 20. I've been doing this a long time because wow. I've been living in America for 27 years. And I wow. knew that... the culture is all we had. I mean, I came to Brooklyn. I didn't like what I saw. So when I had a chance, I think at age 28, I'm going to be 45 this year. I literally walked off the job.
Wow.
Literally. Ooh. I literally walked off the job and said, guys, I'm leaving. Them kept there. I said, Randy, mud. Let me tell you, Jamaica was calling me so bad to capture the culture. I always wanted to do it. And I started filming. I slept outside of Auntie Lena. You see the woman with herbs? That's my auntie.
Oh, yes, yes.
That's Auntie Lena. So I did this because I knew that at some point, the world would get to a point where we would forget ourselves. So part of the film and the stuff that I do is to constantly remind us. Constantly.
I think that was the first video that I watched when I already said it's Norway in Manchester.
Yeah.
And then you could see the the green vegetables, the mountain, the fog. It just looks so real. And like, you just want to suck in some of the fresh air in your lungs and just...
Yes.
You know what I mean?
Yes. To find Jamaicans now who are understanding the program, because I'm doing a, as an artist, I'm doing a program in to kind of satisfy the soul.
Yes.
When we get here, we do lose a part of us.
Oh, yes.
Because the subconscious is a thing. If you don't feed it, you know.
You're gonna
whatever around you is feeding your subconscious.
So, yes.
So this project is a feeding for the spirit.
Yeah.
A visual. That's why when people encounter it, that's why I want you guys to reach out to me. Don't be afraid. I don't bite. Me no look bad, right, Ben?
No, he doesn't bite.
Ren did not bite. You see the phone number upon the video. No, link me. Ben was brave. She said, you know, this Randy guy, I like this. She liked one of my artwork. That's why I'm here with her. And she called me. A lot of people hear me talking and stuff. Them she don't know who like them friend. Jamaica.
And more females need to come out?
Yes. And
we
talk
need,
to Randy.
To
I'm all about the culture and... No, as far as it, Ven, you've been here 10 years. What are some of the tips you can give Jamaican women or Jamaican men? Start with a woman first. Survival tips. What are some of the things you've learned you could pass on to the village?
One, as I said, we come here and we work very hard. Make sure at the end of the day, you have something to go back home to.
Mm-hmm.
Never lose interest in your country. Never lose interest in your culture. You work hard. Don't get up into the Louis bag and the Brazilian hair. And no, I'm not saying that you can't fix up yourself. Yes, because I do it. But at the end of the day, I'm not going to go and buy a Louis bag for $100 when I have a door to buy to put on my house in Jamaica. You know, so that's one of the things I would tell people. Make sure at the end of the day, you have something to go back home to. Forget about people say, them you go to Jamaica, them now go back down there, them are going to rob you and them are going to kill you. Since I've been here, every single year I've been back to Jamaica, apart from last year.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I go twice a year, you know. And Jamaica is like anywhere else where you have good and you have bad.
Mm-hmm.
So never you talk about, you now go back to Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
I remember because home the land that I built my house, it's kind of on a slope, and I had to build a stone wall. And when the stone wall was about to start making, I went to Jamaica, and I put on my sneakers. I'ma get pickaxe and I'ma dig foundation. Oh yeah.
For your house?
Oh yeah. And I dig found. I have it even on video.
You dig foundation for your house?
Oh yes. Not because I live in America, I go back, I can't do it.
Mm-hmm.
And when everybody, Lord, when you come from Friday, can you come and dig? But say, listen, this is for me.
Mm-hmm.
And as my mother would say, ask can too good for care mona grass.
Ask can too good for care mona grass.
Because the grass is where I'm food. So why am I better than care of the food I'm going to eat?
Mm-hmm.
No.
Mm-hmm.
And that's another thing. There's some of the little things that I've learned from my parents, I actually said, man, not be enough for my raise, you know. I call my mother, Mr. May, what you talk about? No, because this man have him goat. Him a raise goat. Him not have nowhere for raise goat.
Why may I capture this? Because you're a real Jamaican. You're a real Jamaican.
Even my friends, they would say, boy, when you come like say your granny, you grow with. You just know them. Old something like I said to her, my girlfriend was saying to me, she have a little cousin. And she said, you look like the little pit one broke out in her. I said, chicken, I got biggest seat 9 foot.
Chicken, I got do
what? Chicken, I got biggest seat 9 foot. Yeah, it means from the small, you can see what they're heading to. You can, you can see what they're heading to when a child's small. Chicken have the biggest seat 9 foot. When my mother raised her for them and she take up, she's here, she said, the one here not go big, you know. You see, my foot them fine. And she took up another one, she said, the one here go big, man. Look on your foot them, how you big? Chicken have the biggest seat 9 foot.
Oh, then, chicken's gonna be big, you're sitting them foot.
No, not, we don't do it that way. We don't do it the New York way.
I'm just explaining to them.
Oh.
If chicken is gonna be big, you will sit in their feet.
Right.
Okay. Yeah.
So all these little things, you know, we kind of keep them or preserve all them little things. Two are better than one when it's not upon the same shoulder.
Wow.
It means we could be thinking about going down the road. And you say, where you going to park? But at the end of the day, the two of us think, may I look up on one side, you are looking on the other side for a park.
Mm-hmm.
The two of us thinking together, but we're heading up on the same shoulder.
Change that direction. New York City and men, American men, your experience. The man experience, the relationship.
I don't have any experience, to be honest, with men in New York. I don't. I've never dated anybody here.
There in Jamaica?
When I came here, I got married in Jamaica to a Jamaican man. We were born and raised on the same road, and I came here.
So you're still in relations with him?
I'm not in a relationship with him, but we are friends. And since then, for the past 6 years, I'm living in my home.
Mm-hmm.
I've never... So I can't say, oh, men in New York is good or they're bad. I don't know.
So you stuck it out with your Jamaican man.
Oh, yes. I don't want to date. And it's not like I don't want to date anymore. But I don't think I'd want to date somebody outside of Jamaica.
Outside of Jamaica?
Yeah. Meaning that I would never date another race, another culture.
Oh, okay.
Another person from another country.
So he was your husband with the two kids?
Yeah.
Wonderful.
But after coming here, it didn't work out. But we're friends.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
We're very good friends.
Your daughters went to college and everything?
Yeah, well, my daughter is still in Jamaica. She's the one who monitored the house in Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And the other one here, she's in college. She's studying geology.
If you were to explain what a Jamaican woman is in 5 minutes to a man, what is a Jamaican woman need, emotions? What's a Jamaican woman?
I think Jamaican woman, the main thing that they need, attention. Jamaican woman, we love attention. We're strong people and we don't take crap.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we don't. We're very strong, but we love attention. And lies, no. Because the minute we find out that you're lying, just come and you will hear a woman say, why am I meet this guy now? I prefer him just tell me the truth.
Mm-hmm.
Just tell me the truth. Say I'm a woman and if I decide for day with him, yeah, I'm going to go there with him. Yeah, you have some woman. And just like I tell my girlfriend, I say, listen, if a man come to me and him tell me, say, boy, I like him, and him say, you know, I'm living with somebody. But I say, listen, if you're there with the Queen of England, I'm a one there with you, I'm going to go there with you.
Mm-hmm.
But just tell me the truth, you know. So mm-hmm. Jamaican woman, they like when you just be upfront.
Mm-hmm.
Just be upfront. And give them the attention that they need.
Mm. But in a way, business-wise, they're very forward-thinking and they're going to get what they want.
If a Jamaican woman say, listen, I want that. If she say, oh, you know, I want that car, she's going to work for it. She's going to work for it. It's just that for me, I just think that more Jamaicans... And not only women, more Jamaicans need to go back home, do things, build your community. You can start from just your community.
Mm-hmm.
Because I actually wanted to start something like that. I didn't know how to start it, honestly. And they have a golden age home in my community.
Mm-hmm.
And because of my kind of job, I could get certain things for old people.
Mm-hmm.
And I would... pop them up in my apartment and say, oh, I'm going to send them to Jamaica. And at one point I say, you know what? It's costing me to send stuff down there.
Mm-hmm.
Even though it's to help people.
Mm-hmm.
But if the government in Jamaica could find a way for people like us who want to send back things to the community to help,
mm-hmm.
to build a community,
mm-hmm.
it's good.
Actually, on the way today, you know, I rant on my videos. You hear me ranting.
Yeah.
You hear me ranting.
Yeah.
sometimes when you're so passionate about the country, mm-hmm. and you get a chance, you just
you just get off and you can't stop chatting.
You just go. and I welcome that from my audience when I talk to them, because we all have a feeling and a passion. Mm-hmm. And I just said, if Jamaica asked us for $5,000 a piece, you know, mm-hmm. and it was transparent, we'd have a big hospital right now in Jamaica.
Oh yes.
And I say it's lack of visionary leadership. You know, they mean well, but they don't have the vision.
The vision.
The innovative
ideas. And some of them down there too, we must talk about those, the untrustworthy ones.
Yes, yeah.
The untrustworthy ones. My daughter is Anthony, she down there. She, this is not because she's my daughter. I think she get that from me, because when I was living in Jamaica, I have friends who live here who would, I would have their bank book down there. Mm-hmm. And they would send the money to me and I deposit it mm-hmm. into their account. Mm-hmm. Now when they come, they can see where I deposit every single cent.
Mm-hmm.
When building that house down there, if I send $600 and give my daughter and I say, okay, buy some tile with this. She would take a picture of the tile, a picture of the receipt, and send it to me. Then she would video everything in the house and send it to me. Now some people don't have that. Not a lot of us have people you can trust like that.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
One of my vision for my community
mm-hmm.
is to buy tools. The first thing I said I was going to buy is a jackhammer.
Mm-hmm.
Because building the house, I learned to buy a lot of tools that I didn't even know about.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I would send them down and I say, you know, you could buy the tools, send them down, train people to use them, even rent them.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And rent them. And you have something coming in down there while somebody else is benefiting from it. I mean, a lot of the guys them down there, they don't want to, they're not interested in that.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, if you can get one
mm-hmm.
out of 10, to learn a trade,
mm-hmm.
Then you know you're achieving something.
So Jamaica needs tools.
Yes, I think so. And I think a lot, if most of us who are here would go back to our respective community and do something.
With tools.
With tools.
Because we're talking to Hugh and he mentioned he know where to get tools at discount. You know,
yeah.
I don't know if you listen
yeah,
to the
I listen to that one. I listen to him.
And I'm glad that we're on the same page. So for practical purposes, if we say put a tool in your barrel every time you go down,
right,
that would be a big plus.
Of course, it would be a big plus, because I do it.
I went to Jamaica and I couldn't even find a sledgehammer. I said, anybody sledgehammer?
Yeah, they don't have it. And you have so much construction worker down there.
Yeah, you're right.
But send down jackhammer,
mm-hmm.
weed walker, jackhammer, the spray paint bottle, I bought them,
mm-hmm.
send them, because my daughter, they don't pay anybody to paint the house, and she do it herself.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
She did it herself.
I think this platform we're building is only going to expand. To think that I've just started with the Jamaica Radio thing, mm-hmm. I'm more focused, and then I'm driving to interview you, you contact me. It's becoming more of a passion. People are telling me, Randy, keep doing this.
Oh yes, told you, I tell everybody. I was talking to Diane today and she said, and I said, oh, as Randy video, you know, when I watch it, she said, Ven, every time I talk to you about this Randy, you remember when we used to watch Dr. Adze, I say, everything you talk about Dr. Adze, well, at the same way, I feel now everything you say, Randy. I'm like, yeah, you need to go on YouTube and watch. And she said, she do. And most of the people, all of the people who I actually told about the channel, they do watch it.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
As a friend of mine said, he's living in Jamaica, and he said, boy, Ven, Mr. Mayor watched it, you know, and yo, he's let me say, all right, I don't watch it when I go on my bed. I'm going to see you next one, I'm going to click on it, and I say, Ven, I don't watch it when I go on my bed. And before me know it, I'm morning. You know, it made me feel good, because at least I know,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
even though he's in Jamaica, he's still interested in something like this.
Yeah, man.
Because a lot of us, we come here, and it's when we migrate from Jamaica.
Yeah.
That's when we appreciate what we have in Jamaica.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
For me, I tell him, no. it's not just since I come to America I appreciate Jamaica. Mm-hmm. I've been appreciating Jamaica.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
As I said before, I drove to the 14 parishes in Jamaica.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I might not know every district in every parish, I can't, but mm-hmm, mm-hmm. every parish I drove to.
Mm-hmm. I'm so very happy I'm getting a feminine perspective, a real powerful Jamaican woman, because it's been a lonely journey, me alone trying to lift up the positivity every time. And just so you guys know, if you see a comment, me read all the comments, you know. Because me now watch, you know. Me know everybody. Me watch, you know.
You know, I don't comment.
Let me tell you something, Vin. Let me tell you something. If I see an ounce of negativity, you get banned. You literally get banned for show up on the channel. This is why more and more you see the comments. Wow, these comments are pretty positive.
Yeah.
The minute you raise up your head of negativity, may just delete it.
No, because the movement is positive, moving forward.
Yeah.
And negativity is something that pull you back.
Yeah. There, I envision a couple of years from now, I want to keep interviewing people. Reach out to me, people, Jamaicans. I can't do this alone. It's going to happen where we're going to build a spreadsheet of contacts and resources, bringing tools back. Eventually,
yeah.
All of you are going to put on top of the inner
side. And I'm willing to put up a tool. I am ready and willing. I'm ready. I'm honestly ready. And don't think about, the tool now go in my community. No, don't think about it. It's going to your country.
The first thing when I sit on a Jamaica, 2011, I recorded a video about Baba House. I mean, just see the video recently. I'm saying, Lord, got too much work for Dorandi. And I said I was going to buy a minibus, a bus in the community for transport the kids them.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I had a vision about selling the pictures and getting people together and raising money and buy the van for the farmer and stuff like that. And it's been so heavy. It's been so burdensome and working and balancing the mission and everything. And no, people are knowing my name.
Yes.
Them understand I'm building a brand so they can know me personally, and we build a trust among each other. Because now with all man called Big Heart, the man have 20 acres of Jamaica, we find our seed bank man. Mm-hmm. No, you.
Oh yes, I went to the seed bank and he was like, I label them, I put them for dry, and I label them. You know, I was listening to that one too.
You have him seed bank.
Yep.
Then we have you now in our Kingston 7 build your own house. And what I want to do is to keep on finding professionals and this survival. When we do go to Jamaica now, we have a network of people. You have Hugh, construction,
mm-hmm.
tools. So something will come of it when the time is right and the community, with little virtual community we're building, the trust among us. Something will come later based on the spirit, I'm not sure.
And I must say, the house that I built, it's between me and my daughter, my two daughters. Because the one down there, she came in with some inheritance. And we start together. We build together. The one that is here, when she get off doing our summer jobs, and if we say, oh, we need to buy 4-door locks, she said, oh, mommy, I'll buy the 4-door locks. So we pull together.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not just to say, oh, I came here and I may alone started this thing from scratch, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's me and my two girls.
This is another thing. I think together is the word I'm always pushing towards.
Yeah.
Because right now, no hospital, no, they are Jamaica, I know.
Oh my God.
No big hospital. I'm thinking with the right leadership, this viewership on this channel is going to get to hundreds of thousands.
And the thing that I like with your channel also.
Yeah.
You don't speak about the government.
No.
As some people do.
No.
As you're hoping them. Boy, the government of Jamaica now do nothing.
No.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
No. What about we doing for ourselves?
Yeah.
Pull together.
Yeah.
I in my job, as I said, the other day I had boxes
mm-hmm.
of adult pull-ups
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
that they was gonna throw out.
Mm-hmm.
And I said to the lady, I said, no. I send them to Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
Because they're very expensive down there, mm-hmm. and people need them. Mm-hmm. And she said, okay. And I'll take taxi every time I'm coming from work.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And a friend of mine, he's from Augustown also, Wiley, he's doing a wonderful job. And I gave them to him. I said, send them down.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So whatever I can send back to Jamaica, it's not just, oh, I'm going to send one barrel of food.
Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. Or I'm going to buy some clothes and pack the barrel. No, I've never sent a barrel to Jamaica. And I've sent numerous barrels down there. Mm-hmm. Because of my house, I buy things here mm-hmm. and send down. And I've never sent a barrel to Jamaica where I don't say, put something in there for our elderly.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I always try to do that.
I'm so happy that the community is we're getting together. We're listening. The people are on the channel and they mm-hmm. realize there's an authentic approach to this. It's not radio. This is not news. Today's news. This is people business. My intention when I 25 years ago, Father said, build Jamaica Radio. I said, man, God. That's kind of heavy.
Right?
But my uncle told me recently it wasn't time. But no, let me tell you something, Ven. For me to actually mm-hmm. live in the moment and mm-hmm. actually know that when I upload this video, every time I upload that video, me just see the village them come. It's like, the man say, Randy, where the video today? Where the video yesterday? You never.
It's like they want a video every day. Because I look forward to them too.
You know?
The other day, my
breakfast, I said, I better record this and send them, tell them, I'm still alive. Because if they don't get a video.
Right? And which is good. And trust me, it is because people are interested in what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
If they wasn't interested in what you're doing, you think they would treat it? They wouldn't.
True. Yeah, yeah.
You know, and they see that what you're doing is something good.
Positive.
Right, it's something positive.
So I want you guys to reach out to me, JamaicaRadio@gmail.com. JATalkRadio@gmail.com. Go to JamaicaRadio.com. You'll see my number there. Number below this video with Ven. This is a regular. No, she live near the neighborhood. After I come from Africa, I come check her again for talk foolishness because me love her. She just sung, hit the last night. Hit the night and sign it off for me. Say it, Ven. Lord, give thanks.
Oh, which one do you want to hear now? Oh. On the bank of the beautiful river, meet me there. Brother, will you meet me there, right over there? On the bank of the beautiful river, meet me there when my journey's end. Lord, upon the bank of the beautiful river, meet me there. Brother, will you meet me there, right over there on the bank of the beautiful river, meet me there when my journey is end.
All right, clap yourself, run up in that church, clap yourself. This is Jamaica Radio, SaveJamaica.com. Yours truly, Randy Pottinger, and Ven, Lady V, Mayor Carlar. This is one of my first interviews in the car with someone that I met on YouTube. Again, Jamaicans, bless up on yourself, take care of yourself. Gonna 20, Brett, give shout out to your family, Ven.
I just want to say more love to all my Jamaican people. Stay all your culture, don't forget it. Shout out to my two girls, Jody K, Antoinette, my niece, Tiffany, Raymond. And my mom, Miss Ermine from up at the hill, where I plant all of the food, the cassava, the yam. She makes a lot of amini porridge. I mean, genuine amini porridge. She makes asham. A lot of you guys don't know asham.
Yes, sugar and corn in the mortar.
She dry the corn, she make her corn dumpling. We make cassava dumpling.
Wow.
So guess what? Big up yourself, Miss Ermine.
Meet me, dear, on the riverbank. We say we love it, man. Jamaica culture and the vibe. When people say to me, New York or Jamaica, it is not a question. The vibe and the culture.
Yeah, big up yourself, Miss Ermine.
Big up more people. Come, yeah, go send it out to them, you know. Make sure say you call them name, guys. How come
Wayne Raymond, big up yourself for one brother. Love you. Or big up now, Diane, Michelle. You know, big up all of my Jamaican friends. Oh, Collins Michael, how could I forget you? You are an authentic Jamaican. Trust me, love you, brother. Yep.
Make sure them link Randy.
Make sure go on YouTube and look for Randy Pattinger. Yes. Yeah, go on YouTube for Randy Pattinger. He's and doing meet a me, wonderful job.
Meet me at the bank.
Right?
Respect. Love. All right, until next time, this is the first lady on the show. She made history.
Oh,
ten years from now, when we listen to this, she said, whoa, that was that night on the beautiful bank of the Brooklyn River. But she's the first woman to really represent the culture and the country. So big up yourself.
And thanks to my mother for all of this. Because my mother gave me all of this.
Yeah, and the grandmother and
my
too.
My grandmother. Oh, Mother Raymond. She's from Grovetown, Manchester. Mother Raymond.
Love the Kingston woman them. So, you know, you're planning to build in Kingston. Next time we talk, we want to talk about you going back to Manchester and build too.
Yeah, I want to build in the country, but I don't want to build in Manchester with the red dirt. I'm so.
Come on, man. The red dirt is good. Man.
I know it is good. It's rich, but honestly, that's the only thing I don't like down there.
You don't like your things staying up.
Mm-mm.
All right. Until next time, people. Love or no. Subscribe, hit the bell, and share it. All right? Reach out to me. Don't be afraid. All right? We're not bite. All right? Give thanks. Ben, sign it out.
Let me sign it off with another song from
them. Another song, lick it. Been love singing, or that good.
Oh yeah, I like my Nine Night songs. Oh, get send them me. Oh, get send them. Oh, get send them me. The old bands rule. See, get send them me, oh, get send them me, oh, get send them me, the old band's room. My Jesus prayed until his sweat became blood. Said, and it was for you, Lord, and it was for me, Lord, oh, what an agony, oh, what a pain, King Jesus bear.
You see me the almost, me dead there with your van, me dead there. Until next time, give God thanks and blessings. Ben, one of us big her up, man, and send love to her, make sure know us, enjoy the program. Woman Jamaican out there, Vena, take the lead. Stop being afraid. Man, continue.
Yeah, we want the ladies. Come out. Come out, Jamaican woman.
Yeah, man.
If I do it, you can.
Respect. Next time.